Hey everybody, DJ Hell Nazareth, United City Plugin, and today we're going to discuss how to connect and set up the Tasami On Air Mixer when gaming, broadcasting, and DJing. Several days ago, a subscriber asked, how can I use this on a small DJ setup? And I must admit, not a lot of reviews on this Tasami mixer. Also, not to mention that the manual doesn't explain things very well either. So Mr. Goody or DJ Goody McFly, today's video will help you and others who want to use this mixer properly. So with that being said,
all systems go.
So before I continue, I would like to explain in detail what the Tasami mixer is used for, basically. It isn't a mixer for recording and mixing like a Rode or a Mackie or any of those standard mixers, but more of a mic preamp, which you can connect a mic and other devices at once. In other words, have the output connected to the Tasami or recording device of your choice, which can be used for recording purposes. So if I was to be gaming, it would look something like this, whereas the mixer connected to the speaker, and then I will connect the dynamic part to the other end of the mixer. Then the microphone will go either here or here, whatever you want. Also, the PS4 or Xbox will go to line one. Now, how will it look in an actual scene? It will look like something like this. Broadcasting is similar to the gaming setup, but the only thing is you don't need a gaming console, just a PC and recording software, which you can find online, but I recommend the Audacity or the OBS. Which brings me to the final and often overwhelming setup, DJing. A DJ setup requires plugging to certain equipments, using certain cables, and of course a lot of patience. So let's just jump into it, the DJ setup. A DJ setup is a little complicated at first, but once you get to know about which inputs go to which outputs, everything is a go. Some DJ controls have a dedicated sound card with an output that's already integrated, so you can connect your Tasami mixer to the back of it. So let me be clear, or better yet, let me just show another PowerPoint slide. Let's start with my DJ controller. I need to connect to one of my mixers too, so I need an audio RCA cable to a quarter inch cable, or better yet, an RCA to a quarter inch male cable to the dynamic mic port. Why? Well, that's because the dynamic mic is considered to be an input. Now I want to hear both devices, so I need speakers. So I need another audio cable, 3.5 male, to connect to the earphone slash speaker. Also, I have a primary mixer which has multiple inputs and outputs. So all I need is to connect the earphone slash speaker 3.5 mil from the Tasami mixer to the main output of the standard mixer, and that's it. Now, let's see if I did everything correctly.
Bye.
So this is how I set up most of my devices when using the Tasami mixer. So hopefully this will help everyone who is still stuck on this issue. And by the way, the following cables that I did use in this video will be in the description section below. And if you still have any questions or you're stuck anywhere, just feel free to email us at info@unitedcdjp.com. Once again, info@unitedcdjp.com. To close, the Tasami mixer meets your multimedia needs. It is great for podcasting, online gaming, video conference, and of course, DJing. It has a simple interface with effects that is useful in the modern society. Finally, let me just say this one more time before I end this. The Tasami mixer isn't a mixer for recording and mixing like the Rode or a Mackie or any of those standard mixers, but more of a mic preamp, which you can connect a mic and other devices at once. In other words, have the output connected to the Tasami or the recording device of your own, which can be used for recording purposes. Anyway, I am DJ Hill Nazareth with United City Plugin. Thank you for watching, and of course, stay safe.